The following contest is a Royal Rumble match. Now the two superstars that drew number one and number two will start at the ring at the same time. Other superstars will join in the order that they drew. This will continue until all 30 superstars have entered the ring. Eliminations will occur when a superstar is thrown over the top rope with both feet landing on the floor. The last man in the ring will be declared the Royal Rumble winner and will advance to the main event at WrestleMania. Introducing the participants first. From Austin, Texas, weighing 261 pounds, Dustin Rhodes. From Robbinsdale, Minnesota, weighing 257 pounds, Mr. Perfect.
You know, sometimes a superstar just has that look in his eye, and this is one of those times.
If this one doesn't end up on a highlight reel somewhere, I'll be incredibly surprised.
And there's the bell. These guys are going to be very aggressive. You know they're going to use any means necessary to go home with a win.
What a match this is going to be.
I've been looking forward to this one for a long time, Cole.
Look at that. Now, that's acrobatic.
That reminds me of my matches.
Dustin Rhodes not only has youth on his side, but he also has the benefit of learning from the absolute best, his father, Dusty Rhodes.
And you can tell Dustin has a good head on his shoulders, Cole. There's nothing bizarre about this kid.
Hey, what does Dustin Rhodes need to do to win tonight?
Looking fresh right now, which is good. You gotta wonder how much longer that can last, though.
We'll have our third competitor momentarily.
It'll be interesting to see who becomes the alpha.
Oh, he's coming back in. Mr. Perfect showing us how to get it done.
How's he doing this? Boom, what a slam. Oh, my God, I can't believe it.
I'll bet he can't believe it either. That must have felt awful.
King, I think it's that good head that you mentioned earlier that makes Dustin Rhodes in so much demand when it comes to tag team action. It seems like guys are lining up in the back to be his partner. And the clock hits zero. Here comes another superstar.
Oh, wow, this changes everything. Oh, out of nowhere.
Dustin Rhodes getting completely dominated here, people.
Have you seen anything like this before, Cole? A great European uppercut.
These guys giving this sold-out crowd exactly what they came to see. What an incredible match. Oh, I think this man means business.
Guys certainly are lining up to tag with Dustin, as you mentioned earlier. But Dustin is very choosy over who he forms alliances with.
Oh, that was close. He's coming back through the ropes.
Another superstar is joining in.
Oh, the more the merrier, I always say.
At this point, you think he'd have that move well scouted. That wild strike found nothing but empty air that time.
Man, that's what you call swinging for the fences and missing.
With this kind of attack, you have to wonder just how much longer they compete in this match.
Yeah, I completely agree. The way things are going in there, I'd say not much longer. My gosh, this is a beating.
Today, too fast.
Mr. Perfect is definitely making a statement.
Well, he's mounting some offense now.
Is it tied already? That was fast.
Well, here comes many people's pick to win this thing.
There's a few moves. Oh, the rolling net snap.
Believe me, that is painful.
and he fails to connect with anything that.
And that's it for the Bulldog.
Oh, he missed.
Oh, nobody home that time.
A punch to the gut there.
Oh, man, that had to knock the wind out of him.
Uh-oh. Oh, that was close. He's coming back through the ropes.
You'll be taking those shots to the back of the head sooner or later. You're going to be seeing stars.
Yeah, or at least looking up at the lights.
Dustin Rhodes is definitely making it look easy.
He's definitely in command.
Speaking of signature X-Pac moves, you can't forget the running leg drop or the roundhouse kick, King.
Oh, you're right, Cole. Both are so quick, you just never see them coming. Much like the rest of X-Pac's offense.
See these guys go at it for a long time, and by the sound of this crowd, I think they're getting what they wanted. Here's another competitor.
And look at him, Michael. He looks determined to win this match.
Legs taken out by the Russian leg sweep.
Wait a minute, we're not in Russia, are we? He is connecting with everything. X-Pac is putting on a show.
Great move.
Man, he's still down after that move. I almost wonder if his bell got seriously wrong there.
This high-flying stick of dynamite first exploded onto the WWE scene in the early 90s as the 1-2-3 Kid. After defecting to WCW, he returned to WWE the night after WrestleMania 14 as the newest member of D-Generation X.
I remember watching that night, and when he became known as X-Pac, we saw a different side of this aerial attack.
He's fought out of it.
X-Pac shows us some clever offense here.
Man, that got him good. He landed a perfectly placed strike. That'll send a message to your adversary, all right.
Right, and the message reads P-A-I-N.
X-Pac is...
And that ends Mr. Perfect's night.
Not so perfect. And the turnbuckle does the damage.
Look out!
My God, his body's been through hell, and his ribs have bore the brunt of the attack.
And I hope we can get a doctor out here as a precaution. Damaged ribs like that can make it hard to breathe. One of the greatest superstars of all time. I'll give credit where it's due. Heartbreak Kid's been eliminated.
I don't think there's an area on that back that's not suffering right now.
Yeah, when he wakes up.
Lion Salt. A Lion Salt. Chris Jericho's work's almost done here.
Chris Jericho so impressive here tonight. Oh, wait. Nice reversal. X-Pac shows us some clever offense here. X-Pac has been a part of so many major moments in WWE history that, well, you never know when or where he'll appear. A perfect example of that is when DX made a surprise appearance at WrestleMania 31.
Here's the moment he's been waiting.
He's still in this one. Quick thinking to avoid that.
Reversing it. Incredible.
Oh, that was close. He's coming back through the ropes.
Oh, right to the gut.
He's fought out of it.
We're looking at complete domination here.
You know, guys,
and they pushed it. Bret Hart's been eliminated.
Wow. Jericho's out. I don't know what's going to happen here. Mikey Whipwreck taking advantage right now.
Here comes another superstar.
Oh, man, and it wouldn't surprise me at all if this guy was the last man standing.
Diamond Dallas Page show some clever offense here. X-Pac has him. Not a lot of spring left in his step right now.
Getting his attention with a vicious strike.
And what a reversal from Mikey Whipwreck.
Really pushing his opponent to the limit here.
And that spells the end for DDP.
Yeah, let's see him try to spin this elimination into a positive.
And we've got another superstar entering the match.
And there's a good chance we're looking at the man who will take this thing, Cole. Look at this guy. Oh, he's the guy that's opponent. What's he going for here? Oh, he's coming back in. Oh, look at him. Oh, Dustin Rhodes hit that one.
That was incredible, King.
Nice move.
And what a reversal from Mikey Whipwreck.
And he's still in this.
This is a big risk. Will it pay off?
Look out below.
Look out.
Few superstars are as dominant as this guy.
Going for broke.
Well, that was an incredible move by Mikey Whipwreck.
He's in big trouble. What do we got here? Boy, he just got laid out. What are we going to see here?
His head is taking an unbelievable amount of punishment here. My God, his body's been through hell, and his ribs have bore the brunt of the attack.
Man, I hope we can get a doctor out here as a precaution.
Incredible move by X-Pac.
Once the bat goes, it's nearly impossible to stand, let alone deliver any offense.
Triple H making his presence felt.
You know, I feel like he's always making his presence felt around here.
For years, Monday night has been the most exciting night in sports entertainment, and the action was...
He's still in this one. Oh, that was close. He's coming back through the ropes.
Thank you for choosing to watch WWE on this Monday night. We promise to bring you a...
Is he out? No, he made it back in. And he's tripled up. It doesn't get more painful than that.
Oh, what a shot. That did some serious damage. You can't take too many of those and expect to be in the match much longer.
Ken, just look at this man. He's all business.
And that's the way he has to be if he wants to win here tonight. And that's all for Dustin Rhodes.
He's not known as the Cerebral Assassin because it sounds good or looks cool in a t-shirt. When you step through the ropes against him, Triple H is looking to dissect you physically and psychologically. An opponent better be ready for war.
Oh, Michael, rest assured that the war is going to be physical. It's going to be psychological, and it's going to be the fight of that man's life. And it can all come to an end with one pedigree. Oh, that was close. He's coming back through the ropes.
You have to possess a different type of focus to punish an opponent like this.
Yeah, you really have to enjoy hurting someone. X-Pac reverses it. Look out! Look out!
And a powerful slam down onto the back.
Now that is force. What strength.
And he's still in this.
There's the suplex.
That was nice.
Oh, and he missed that one. God, that's gotta hurt. And fresh superstar just entered the match. A huge advantage for the newcomer.
A huge advantage indeed, considering the guys in the ring have been going at it for quite some time now. X-Pac taking advantage here. This could be big.
Few superstars are as dominant as this guy.
He's fought out of it. He's got him. Boom!
What an impact. That was thunderous. Talk about feeling something through the entire arena.
Got out of the way of that one. Oh, he's coming back in.
Look out. Here comes Jimmy Uso.
Yeah, and he's not wasting any time, is he, Michael?
Joe is down.
And he went down hard.
Oh, out of nowhere.
And he just got nailed.
Michael, I think Triple H is injured. Could this be it for the King of Kings? And there's the reversal from Samoa Joe.
You can't put a price tag on landing that perfect strike. And that nailed him. Samoa Joe is definitely making it look easy.
It may just be a matter of time now, Cole.
Oh, that was close. He's coming back through the ropes.
Get ready, folks. Get ready.
He's fought out of it. Huge power move.
My God, his body's been through hell, and his ribs have bore the brunt of the attack.
And I hope we can get a doctor out here as a precaution. Damaged ribs like that can make it hard to breathe. He's pulling out all the stops tonight.
And he's still in this. Well, that's it for X-Pac.
Oh, you said it best earlier. Being the opponent of Triple H is like being in a war. I mean, it's important to remember that it can all end with one pedigree. It's that simple. And you
wow, what a move from Triple H. That's how
Lex Luger's out.
He may be trying to systematically chop his opponent down, starting at the bottom. Nobody home there.
Nobody home? Cole, that looked like the house has been empty for months.
He's fought out of it.
Man, that got him good. He landed a perfectly placed strike. That'll send a message to your adversary, all right.
Right, and the message reads, P-A-I-N.
Oh, look at this. Three eliminations. He's making his presence felt in this match.
You know, King, we talked about it before, all the elements that make up the game and how an opponent has to be physically and mentally prepared. The match will be a war. That's all for Samoa Joe. Looking good now. WWE Magazine out this month, and you'll find some interesting articles in there about all the superstars here in WWE.
Who do you get to read the magazine to, you, Cole?
When he gets going like,
and now Jimmy Uso could have this match in the bag.
How much damage did that do?
A lot from the looks of it.
One of these guys is going to walk away with the win here tonight. I just can't imagine one of them also accepting defeat. And now Jimmy Uso sent to the back.
I'm not sure what it was, but something wasn't right with Jimmy Uso tonight.
This Samoan giant was first seen in WWE in the early 90s as Fatu. During the Attitude Era, the descendant of the famous Anoa'i family exploded into the scene as part of the trio known as Too Cool.
Rikishi found his stride, all right. I remember the 2000 Royal Rumble when he eliminated 7 WWE superstars. The big man was also an Intercontinental Champion, World Tag Team Champion, and WWE Tag Team Champion.
And he's still in this.
Look out.
Wow, he's still down after that.
So much of Rikishi's career has been about putting smiles on people's faces. There's one time we'd all like to forget when he was revealed as the driver who deliberately hit Stone Cold Steve Austin with his car at the 1999 Survivor Series.
Man, Triple H, what offense! He's got him hooked.
What's he gonna do here?
God, there was nothing accurate about that attempt at offense.
Oh, you're being too kind. Some people would use other words to describe what we just witnessed.
Look at the attack here.
Oh, man, talk about a direct hit. Reversal. Rikishi showing his skills. Well, we've talked about Rikishi's career, and yes, he won his share of WWE gold, has fans all over the world, and of course, a full repertoire of impressive dance moves. But you have to talk about one more thing.
I don't believe it! It's game over for the game!
He's in full-on attack mode now.
Uh-oh.
Here's another competitor.
And look at him, Michael. He looks determined to win this match.
Well, that missed him all right.
Hey, did you look before firing? What an idiot. Oh, what a shot.
Check out WWE.com. You'll find updates and blogs from all your favorite superstars.
Yeah, and don't forget to check us out on Twitter. It's at Jerry Lawler and at Michael.
And Rikishi nails it.
And here he is, the fire-breathing dragon, Ricky Steamboat. Oh, he's coming back in.
Wow, that overhand punch started down behind his feet and just kept coming.
Woo-hoo, man, that came out of left field.
He's fought out of it.
He's sending a message to the entire.
Rikishi has been finished.
Nobody home there.
Nobody home? Cole, that looked like the house has been empty for months.
Just making his presence felt there.
Look out!
Another superstar is about to join the match.
You know what? We might just be looking at the next WrestleMania main eventer. One of my favorite things about Mr. McMahon is that he'll oftentimes adopt the finisher of whoever he's facing in the ring.
Oh, that was close. He's coming back through the ropes.
This is a level of destruction no one was expecting.
I certainly didn't expect to see this kind of damage.
He's fought out of it.
Mr. McMahon getting completely dominated here, folks.
To King's earlier point, there's few things funnier than seeing Mr. McMahon pull off the corporate elbow or the McMahon stunner. Say hello to Bam Bam Bigelow's greeting from Asbury Park. This has got to be the end.
Bam Bam Bigelow, he's a beast.
The fight's being brought right to it.
No kidding, this is tough. Oh, what a thorn.
Pushed him out. They got him out.
Bam Bam Bigelow's night has come to an end.
Well, bye-bye, Bam Bam.
We're looking at...
he's coming back in.
Oh, Mr. McMahon knows how to polish off an opponent.
What a forceful attack to the back region. He's stalking his opponent from the top turnbuckle.
Whoa, whoa! Mr. McMahon getting completely dominated here, folks.
I think it's fair to say that Mr. McMahon carries that same ruthlessness from the boardroom right into the ring.
Well, you got to give him credit, Cole. It's that ruthlessness that has made him such a success over the years.
For years, Monday night has been the most exciting night in sports entertainment, and the action we're seeing here is a lot of the reason why.
Not today, too fast.
glass. Ricky the Dragon Steamboat softened up here.
Here comes another superstar.
Oh, man. I hope they reinforce the ring for this one.
He's inflicting some serious pain here. Rufus in the ring. Yes, a ring technician, however.
Well, Ramon, there it is.
And that could be the difference maker for Ramon.
Man, oh man, did he take a wild swing with that one.
You're right. That was wild indeed. Good thing we're over here. Somehow, he's kicked it into another gear here tonight.
He's fought out of it.
He lands the... Wow, what a move from Mr. McMahon. That's how you sweep an opponent under the carpet.
Oh, wait, nice reversal.
When this guy's on, look out.
Yeah, but to your earlier point, Cole, if he wins anyway, does it...
And over the top rope goes Ricky the Dragon Steamboat.
Double chicken wing. The fox is in the hen house.
That's the last place you want the fox to be.
Looking fresh out there. You're not going to lose many matches. What a match this is going
to
be.
I've been looking forward to this one for a long time, Cole.
Scott Hall spent so much time along his 7-foot partner in crime, Kevin Nash, that people lose sight that Hall stands 6'7" and weighs almost 200.
That's it. He's out. Ricky the Dragon Steamboat has found an answer here.
Steven Regal look any less pleasant as he makes his way to the ring here.
Well, he's certainly not coming down here to make any friends, Cole.
Notch, good luck sitting down tomorrow after that atomic drop.
He's gonna need one of those inner tubes to sit on.
This will be a physical battle.
You're right about that, Cole. This is going to be a war. This could be so physical that it gets really ugly before it's over. Whoa, there he goes. Scott Hall is gone.
These are great competitors. Great.
He's out. Oh, no. I wonder what the consequence will be from this. Without a doubt, Lord Steven Regal is one of the most polished scientific wrestlers WCW has ever seen. Between his array of suplexes, hammerlocks, and leg locks, I don't think there's a move that Regal doesn't know. Look at this. He's in full control of this one.
These guys are giving it their all here tonight, not just to entertain the fans, but to ultimately walk away with the win. It won't take long for the aggression to escalate quickly in this one.
You're right, Cole. These two don't like each other, and we're going to find out how much they really do dislike each other in this match.
I'd agree that Regal is extremely proficient when it comes to scientific wrestling. But what impresses me the most is how effortless he makes it look. I mean, he just rolls into a surfboard like it's second nature. We're going to slap on a cross-faced chicken when
he's still in this one.
Offense here.
Jey Uso has fire in his eyes now.
Thank you for choosing to watch WWE on this Monday night. We promise to bring you a great night of action. Time for another superstar to join the match.
I wouldn't be in any hurry to get down to that ring. It's not a race, you know.
when it comes to the best DDTs in the business.
Is he out? No, he made it back in.
And Lord Steven Regal is making full use of this open moment.
Well, he's got his opponent, and what's he going for here?
Oh, he's coming back in.
He's simply reminding him that he's here.
Oh, out of nowhere!
Unleashing it for the second time now.
Jey Uso, no problem getting out of that one.
Uh-oh. Is he out? No, he made it back in.
Here's the moment he's been waiting for.
I'll tell you, I wouldn't be surprised if he was among the last few in there, Cole.
He's fought out of it.
I'd agree that Arn Anderson does have a stellar DDT, but you also have to keep an eye out for his knee drop and figure four leg lock.
Yeah,
and Lord Steven Regal's been sent packing.
Man, that's a tough loss for Regal.
Wearing down the opposition here.
Oh, wait, nice reversal.
Shane McMahon turns it around.
Yep,
there's the reversal by Arn Anderson.
Man, that was smooth. Yeah, what's going on here?
Here comes another superstar.
Oh, man.
Is he out? No, he made it back in.
Here. Jey Uso showing some adversity right now.
No, not again.
Look at this. Arn Anderson has been eliminated.
Well, whether Shane McMahon's diving off the highest fixed point in an arena onto an opponent or announcing that he's leading an alliance, the Boy Wonder's responsible for some of the most shocking moments in sports entertainment.
Underhook suplex.
This is a level of destruction no one was expecting.
No kidding, this is getting ugly.
This might be big.
Taken down with a beautiful suplex. See what kind of response we'll get.
Yeah, I'm telling you, that suplex was perfect.
Sometimes the best offense is a great...
And that's it for Jey Uso.
Jerry, we all know Shane McMahon can be flamboyant, cocky, impulsive, and a slew of other adjectives. But one thing he most certainly is above all else, that's fearless.
Of course, Shane is all those things, but you know what? So is every other successful media mogul. You don't reach such heights by having the work.
Shane McMahon couldn't get it done. After everything we've witnessed, it comes down to this. Which one of these combatants will win?
William Regal reversing it. Incredible.
Look at Flair zeroing in on his opponent with the precision of a fine craftsman at work. It's like the Nature Boy is going a mile a minute in there. Rick's always been revered for his superior cardiovascular conditioning.
We might be seeing the beginning of the end. You know, Regal's version of the STF. Yet another one for the highlight reel. Ric Flair is taking full control right now.
Oh, that was close. He's coming back through the ropes.
Man, he's gotta feel great.
Here's your winner, the Nature Boy, Ric Flair.
He gets a victory here tonight. Love him or hate him, that was an incredible match.
An incredible match and a big, big victory.
Maybe William Regal needs to go down to the WWE Performance Center and learn how to do this whole wrestling thing over again.
Guys, I have to say, that was an amazing match. Waiting for the bell before they get at each other.
Yeah, saying that these two hate each other would be an understatement. Look at him go, Cole.
Now the referee's able to get some order here, and it looks like the match will finally get started. Here we go now. The match is officially underway. What can we expect out of these two, King?
Well, probably more of the fighting we just saw. I mean, they both have a grudge that they want to settle against each other. He's gonna get hurt in this match.
Quick thinking to avoid that.
Oh no, we know what this is. The end of days, can you say end of the world?
Yeah, it's the end of that guy's world.
Definitely looking confident in this one-on-one environment. We're gonna find out who's the better competitor, that's for sure. No gimmicks here, just some good old-fashioned one-on-one action.
People have been wanting to see these guys go at it for a long time, and by the sound of this crowd,
two,
I think they're getting what they wanted.
Three.
Each of these competitors is looking for the slightest hint of weakness in the other.
Well, that's a strategy you have to always have in the back of your head, Cole. If you ever see a weakness in your opponent, you gotta jump on it. You don't want to get caught outside the ring for too long.
What happened to you? You used to love being outside the ring.
Man, there's something about that maniacal laugh of Jim Neidhart's that sends chills down my spine. How about the 180? Jim the Anvil Neidhart, the reversal. How about the 180? Jim the Anvil Neidhart, the reversal.
Incredible move by Jim the Anvil Neidhart.
Finisher! This match,
can he do it here?
This may be it.
Two.
You know, you're right again, King. That laugh of Neidhart's is frightening, but even more scary is the fact that you never know what he's thinking. He's just so unpredictable.
Yep, Bret Hart can attest to that. I don't think he ever anticipated a day where his own brother-in-law would turn on him, but he did.
He's pressing all the right buttons now. He's delivering an old-fashioned kicking right here.
He is just getting busted up. What a counter that was.
And it's Jim the Anvil Neidhart with a reversal. And he goes for the pin.
There's the count.
Not today, too fast.
Oh, no. Jim the Anvil Neidhart is in deep trouble. I mean real deep.
This is what makes him one of the best in the business.
Shoulders down. Is it enough?
It may be.
That stop might have only lasted a second, but it's going to be felt tomorrow.
That may be felt for a lifetime. Oh, looking to put an end to this one. That's it. He's done.
Going for the cover.
One, two, three.
He did it. What a huge win.
Here's your winner, representing the new millennium, the king of old school, Rick.
He earned every bit of that victory here tonight.
That was simply a case of one guy determined to prove his dominance over another.
You got that right, partner. Again, huge win here tonight. Choosing to spend your evening with us. I'm Michael Cole alongside, as always, Jerry the King Lawler.
And I can't think of another place I'd rather be, Michael. This one should be amazing, Michael.
Zack Ryder is a force within the ring. The range of emotions here is startling. There's almost an unknowing of what to expect.
I know. I mean, I got goosebumps. This match is going to be so unpredictable. I just can't wait. I'll admit it. One of my guilty pleasures is Zack Ryder's broski boot. I can't help but woo, woo, woo along with him every time he does it.
I think we got a moment here for Edge. What can you tell us?
Oh, he's coming back in.
We'll have our third competitor momentarily.
What an attack. You must be able to expand your chest in order to breathe.
I bet he feels like he's inside an anaconda. Well, it looks like Edge has got the momentum. Look out! Look out! Oh, man. Cole, what's he got in mind?
Oh, he missed.
Oh, nobody home that time.
We've got a fresh superstar entering the match.
Yeah, and you know, Michael, being fresh is a huge advantage in a match like this.
He's still in this one.
What's Rusev gonna do with this? Oh, no. Wait a minute, Cole. What's he gonna do here?
If you're just tuning in, I want to welcome everyone to this broadcast of WWE, coming to you from the capital of the Golden State, Sacramento.
And he's still in this. He's got him hooked.
Quick thinking to avoid that. Not today, too fast. It's Captain Charisma. It's Christian.
again.
It's an amazing atmosphere in this arena tonight.
Well, you're right. Big fight feel here, no doubt. Why has he got his opponent, and what's he going for here? Christian finds a way out. Look how slow he is to recover here. That was some serious punishment.
This match is being televised around the world in 18 languages in over 110 countries.
Absolutely amazing. The world is watching, and I guarantee Edge has to say goodbye.
Well, when someone's known as the Swiss Superman like Cesaro, that gives you an idea of the range of superior abilities he possesses. Cesaro's immeasurable power, superb technical skills, and all-consuming physical prowess makes him almost...
He's still in this one.
Oh, they couldn't find a home for that one.
Well, it certainly wasn't due to a lack of trying, Michael.
Oh, that was close. He's coming back through the ropes.
Oh, Luke Harper is taking advantage. Oh, out of nowhere!
My God, his body's been through hell, and his ribs have bore the brunt of the attack.
And I hope we can get a doctor out here as a precaution. Damaged ribs like that can make it hard to breathe.
What's he gonna do here? What's he gonna do here?
Statement here with this attack.
We know what Zack Ryder can do in there, and we're seeing it right now. Ryder's showing that underneath the tan sunglasses and stupid looking hair that he can fight.
Look at this. This could be it.
Making a statement here. Oh, incredible move by Zack Ryder. Zack Ryder is a force within the ring. I'm having a hard time figuring out what they're going to do next. Cesaro hits the jackpot with...
And that's it for Christian. Rusev reverses it.
He's in big trouble. Oh!
Oh! Oh, he missed that one. God, that's gotta hurt.
Yeah, you're not doing any damage with swings like that, but keep doing it. The breeze may give him a cold.
He's sending a message to the entire WWE locker room. Cesaro's been eliminated.
Oh, man. I wanted to see the swing again.
Ouch. You can hear that in different time zones.
If you want to talk about high energy, intensity, and a fist-pumping good time, all you have to do is take a ride on the...
And Rusev is eliminated.
Oh, man, hit the showers, Rusev. When he gets going like this, there are a few better.
Andre the Giant can't be enjoying this.
Ow! Ooh.
Andre the Giant can't be enjoying this. Each of these competitors is looking for the slightest hint of weakness in the other.
Well, that's a strategy you have to own. Is he out? No, he made it back in!
Andre the Giant can't be enjoying this.
Man, a ferocious blow.
During a minute ago, you mentioned the energy and passion of Zack Ryder. He's the epitome of the 21st century WWE superstar. Hit him up on social media using the hashtag WWYKI and connect with the Long Island IZ.
Yeah, woo, woo, woo. Sometimes I think Zack needs a little more focus on what's going on in the ring and not what's going on.
Oh, he's coming back in.
Oh, he's got his opponent, and what's he going for here?
Neckbreaker! That was vicious!
This is the...
Oh, that was close. He's coming back through the ropes.
Another superstar is about to join the match.
You know what? We might just be looking at the next WrestleMania main eventer.
Andre the Giant seizes the opportunity. And he gets leveled.
That wild strike found nothing but empty air that time.
Man, that's what you call swinging for the fences
and missing.
Man, somebody's going to be sore in the morning.
Twice as nice. What a wild move by Andre the Giant.
Looking motivated now.
Oh, that was sharp.
Speed and athleticism contributed to a perfectly...
And he's still in this.
Look out.
Is it time already? That was fast.
Well, here comes many people's pick to win this thing.
Oh, that was close. He's coming back through the ropes.
He's got him booked.
He's endured heavy blows here. I don't know how much longer he can go. The referee may have to call this match.
Zack Ryder's been eliminated.
Extra slow getting back to his base here.
With this kind of attack, you have to wonder just how much longer they...
He's fought out of it.
A knockdown, drag-out brawl, complete with a big stomp.
Man, these guys are...
Uh-oh. The big boot has fallen.
And this one may be over.
How much damage did that do?
A lot, from the looks of it.
And he's still in this.
Look out, what's going on here?
Playing mind games.
Yeah, a little intimidation there. Oh, that was close. He's coming back through the ropes.
If you're just tuning in, I want...
Oh, he's coming back in.
He's in full-on attack mode now.
Oh, look out here.
Ladies and gentlemen, Andre the Giant's been eliminated.
Oh my gosh, I can't believe my eyes, Cole.
And he's tripled up.
And now it's down to these two superstars.
Luke Harper looks scary, but just watch his matches. He's taking people's heads off with that boot to the face. I mean, he's breaking jaws with uppercuts, crushing spines with turnbuckle power bombs and sidewalk slams. I mean, at 6'5", he flies through the ropes out onto the floor, too. Luke Harper wants to end.
He's fought out of it.
Oh, this is going to leave some scars, Luke Harper. Folks, Luke Harper is being controlled now.
When this guy's on, look out.
Look out!
Astonishing maneuver by Sheamus. Now that's striking with pinpoint accuracy. You can't take too many of those.
You know, Michael, we could go on and on. But Harper sends opponents into a new world of hurt with a belly-to-back face.
Luke Harper's night's through. It's over. It's all over.
Here's your winner, representing the league, the Celtic Warrior, Sheamus!
Enormous victory right there.
Now you just got to take that win and build off it.
What a match, and thank you for tuning in as we come to you live from Sacramento.
contest is a tag team match, and it is set for one fall. On the way to the ring, from Charlotte, North Carolina, weighing in at 220 pounds, the NXT champion, R-Truth.
The roar in this building can be heard from the street.
It'll be interesting to see how these two teams of three coexist once the bell rings.
See one match than these six. This is going to be great, Michael.
And there's the bell.
Oh, Michael, this is going to be fun to watch. Hey, that's how you do it.
And he fails to connect with anything that time.
Man, that was some miss, all right. I can feel the breeze all the way over here. Oh, wait, nice reversal. Reversal. Barrett showing his skills. Is really going to town right now.
You know, there's never been a WWE superstar quite like R-Truth. He's energetic, explosive, and a little eccentric. But when that bell rings, R-Truth brings his brand of excitement to the ring, which has served him well. Truth is a former United States champion and a former co-holder of the WWE Tag Team Championship.
Tell us about Barrett.
Well, I've seen competitors get lost in the shuffle with all that talent in the ring at the same time, but I don't think we have to worry about that here. Plenty of confidence being shown right now.
Oh, the reversal by R-Truth.
Dance moves and rap lyrics aside, R-Truth has been a respected in-ring competitor in the world of sports entertainment for more than a decade. He's held WWE Championship gold, had his partner in crime, Little Jimmy, been associated with The Miz, and has enjoyed success alongside his friend, Xavier Woods.
Yeah, and when we talk about R-Truth, we can't forget that he's been known to win a dance-off or two. R-Truth's moves in the ring and on the dance floor are equally exciting. That's what's up.
And he finally gets out of the ring.
His strikes have a little extra on them tonight.
This guy's a machine.
What a match this is going
to
be.
I've been looking forward to this one for a long time, Cole. Without a doubt, Lord Steven Regal is one of the most polished scientific wrestlers WCW has ever seen. Between his array of suplexes, hammerlocks, and leg locks, I don't think there's a move that Regal doesn't know.
It's not very often you see six superstars of this caliber competing at the same time.
Finley is looking incredibly impressive as of late. Whoa, whoa, whoa! Finley gets out of that one. Nice move, Fit.
I'd agree that Regal is extremely proficient when it comes to scientific wrestling. But what impresses me the most is how effortless he makes it look. I mean, he just rolls into a surfboard like it's second nature, or can slap on a cross-faced chicken wing out of nowhere. It's amazing.
Yeah, and you know what? When all else fails, he just goes for the cheap shot. He'll even tell you himself, Regal's a dirty, rotten scoundrel.
We're in the feeling out process. Who's going to get the advantage and maintain control?
Your guess is as good as mine, Cole.
Stink dodges trouble.
Well, that's veteran instincts for you. Oh, out of nowhere!
Look at the attack here.
Oh, man. Talk about a direct hit.
This is a wreck. He's moving like an uncaged animal.
No lie, he's wild in there. He's got him. Where did this explosion of offense come from?
He gets the tag. There's the suplex.
That was nice. It's nearly impossible to deal with this type of power.
He gets the tag. And there's an extremely destructive strike.
Ric Flair is not someone to sleep on.
And it's Lord Steven Regal with the reversal.
No, wait, nice reversal.
You know, versatile is a word that comes to mind when I watch Lord Steven Regal compete. He's just so resourceful and can adapt.
The shoulders are down!
Two!
Beautiful escape by Lord Steven Regal.
You know, even on defense, Regal is just so dangerous.
From what we've seen and heard tonight, there must be serious injuries.
No kidding, this is going to need some serious medical attention.
To get with it. I don't know how anyone can condone this.
This referee is not being very impartial.
The action spills out to the ringside area, where there are plenty of toys to help inflict damage.
Regal's versatility certainly is key to his success, but if you ask him which style he prefers best, I'm willing to bet he'd say he'd rather keep it on the mat. He's such an accomplished mat wrestler. That's really where he shines brightest, in my opinion.
Yeah, and while he's down there, he can get his opponents into a wide array of painful submission holds. In fact, I've even seen an opponent submit to Regal while his shoulders were on the mat getting counted out. True story.
You're taking a giant risk with your own well-being anytime you take the action to the outside.
And here comes his partner.
He's doing everything he can to get his bearings back here. Otherwise, this match could be over sooner than anyone could have anticipated.
Yeah, Cole, this is when you have to settle things down. Get the blood flowing back in your body and strategize what your next move or your next form of attack will be. Lord Steven Regal wrestled for 9 years all over the globe before debuting in WCW in the early 1990s. Along the way, he captured many titles, including the British Commonwealth Championship, of which he's quite proud. And now Lord Steven Regal can feel the win within his grasp.
The end may be near. The butterfly suplex, the end is near.
I think you're right there, Cole. This is it.
One, two.
Looking to be in great physical condition here, almost impervious to pain.
Regal's versatility certainly is key to his success. But if you asked him which style he prefers best, I'm willing to bet he'd say he'd rather keep it on the mat. He's such
the arm trap cross leg STF. That'll do it.
That's the longest name in history. Arm trap cross leg STF. The shoulders are down.
Two.
Ouch. You can hear that in different time zones.
Look out.
Would you listen to this crowd show their appreciation for these amazing competitors? Whoa, Lord Steven Regal is dropped like a bad habit.
If you're just tuning in, I want to welcome everyone to this broadcast of WWE, coming to you from the capital, the Golden
State. He takes to the air!
Wow!
Bad News Barrett is a merciless striker who shatters opponents' bones with clotheslines, boots, punches, knee lifts, and wasteland. It's why he calls it the Barrett Barrage. Bad News Barrett just runs through opponents.
My God, his body's been through hell, and his ribs have bore the brunt of the attack.
And I hope we can get a doctor out here as a precaution. Damaged ribs like that can make it hard to breathe.
R-Truth doing some damage.
Oh, once you get out of the ring, anything can happen. You've got exposed steel, concrete, the barricades, and all of it can be used to cause massive damage. Oh, and a terrific reversal.
The face is absorbing a lot of damage here.
I'm not sure I can watch this.
King said it earlier, and it's undeniable. Bad News Barrett truly has one of the most diverse arsenals in the game. And don't forget about that big boot of his, King.
Yeah, forget it. When that size 14 comes at your face, you know you're in big trouble.
And R-Truth tries for an early pinfall.
Reversal.
He gets the tag.
This may settle the score right here.
Figure four leg lock.
Oh man, Cole, let me tell you how bad that hurts.
Just a dominating display.
Yeah, I think we could see a lot of punishment inflicted here.
He goes for the quick pin attempt.
Count, ref, count.
I've seen Ric Flair matches from inside the ring and out. And I gotta tell you, it's a lot better from out here.
At least now I don't have to worry about those chops to the chest.
You might be trying to take out the leg here.
great hold being applied.
I don't believe the destruction we're seeing.
This guy's just going from one painful move to another.
He's making a statement here with this attack.
Oh, look at this. Oh, my gosh. Jumped right on the back of the head. Much more of that, and he's not going to last long.
Chops to the chest aside. What else do you have to look out for when you're in the ring with the Nature Boy?
Well, you know, anything that's illegal. The low blow seems to be his specialty, but he'll also play within the...
And Sting getting it done.
An early pin attempt.
Come on, ref, count.
Work is being put in by Sting. This guy can go toe-to-toe with anybody.
Oh, out of nowhere!
He gets the tag.
Bad news, Barrett's finding a way here with an awesome assault, and we got a bird's eye view. This is something we all know, but it's worth repeating.
Oh, that's it. That's gotta be it. Barrett. Now that's a finishing move, people.
Two.
It won't take long for the aggression to escalate quickly in this one.
You're right, Cole. These two don't like each other, and we're going to find out how much they really do dislike each other in this match.
And Barrett nails it.
His partner's being punished, and he's seen it up.
And now he goes for it a second time. Showing us how to get it done.
Oh! Oh, wait, nice reversal.
Uh-oh, big move coming.
A trained bare-knuckled brawler. Bad news, Barrett can stand up and go toe-to-toe with literally anybody on the roster.
Yeah.
And there's the Scorpion Deathlock. Sting's done messing around and is gonna end it.
Yeah, this is all but over.
What diabolical things are going through that mind right now?
When you get in control like this, the shoulders are down.
He gets the tag.
Barrett shows us some clever offense here.
And now he's back out on the apron. And this seesaw battle has changed again.
Wait, is he still conscious?
Man. And into the cover. King, earlier you mentioned many of Bad News Barrett's admirable qualities. Let's not forget that Barrett's callous, arrogant, brash, and his menacing mentality helped him create the Barrett Barrage.
Wade has so many ways of mauling an opponent. You'd think he transported us from WWE into one of those bare-knuckle rings he ruled back in his native Britain. That's how awesome Barrett's power and mean streak are.
If an opponent exhibits a weakness for a specific move, some will return to utilizing that move as long as possible.
Why not? If it's working, don't change it.
Oh, man, that's gotta hurt. All these power moves tonight are making bigger and bigger impacts. That arm is now in an extremely compromising position.
And there's the release. What's going to happen now?
I'm scared to ask.
And I'd love to disagree with you on your earlier statement, Cole, but I'm afraid you're right. Anybody who loves delivering bad news as
McCover here.
Two.
Let's just hope the action doesn't make its way over to us at the announce table.
Is there anybody more dangerous than Finley when he gets going like this? Incredible counter.
Quick thinking to avoid that.
Oh, he's in trouble now.
Keep in mind,
Can he do it here?
This may be it.
He's seen enough. Here he comes.
Hey, he's going for it again. And the offensive display by Lord Steven Regal.
Finley's Celtic cross looks so simple, but it's really so effective. When he drops his opponent, he's dropping his entire body weight down at the same time the back, shoulders, and neck are slamming into the mat. Ouch!
The offensive Lord Steven Regal is working well right now.
Even if you can get back to your feet after a move like that, at this stage of the match, you're still struggling to find your balance.
A wild overhead punch wreaking havoc in here.
No kidding, that shot came out of nowhere. Oh, out of nowhere!
Textbook reversal by Finley.
You know, that's what years of global experience can bring to the table.
We've seen just how effective Finley's Celtic cross can be. He's beat many top names with that move, including Kane, Jack Swagger, and Rey Mysterio, to name a few.
Yeah, you know what I like best about the Celtic cross?
It's that makes the cover.
The referee getting involved now. And the ref starts to count.
Suplex.
All these power moves tonight are making big
shoulders down. Is it enough?
This may be it.
The referee getting involved now.
Oh, man, from the higher end district.
I wouldn't know what that's like.
He wants back in this match in the worst way.
King, many people refer to Ric Flair as the dirtiest player in the game. You've been in the ring with him. Is he really that dirty?
Let me tell you, he's earned every bit of that nickname and then some. I'm surprised I still have both eyes considering the amount of times he's poked them.
You can bet every superstar on the roster is crowded around the monitors in the back to see which one of these guys comes out victorious.
With a great offensive show.
What an all-star ensemble in the ring right now. Six of WWE's most successful competitors for sure. Barrett tags in. Showing a great deal of faith and trust in that move. Looking for the quick pin.
I don't think even the referee was ready for that.
And the ref starts to count.
Barrett's in major trouble right now. This could be a turning point in the match. Up the turnbuckle goes R-Truth.
Uh-oh.
That'll have you worrying about long-term injuries for sure.
Wow. He's still down after that. Look out, Bo!
Look out!
Oh, what's he gonna do to follow that up? This match has taken so much out of this guy, he's not gonna give up. But man, this has been physical.
Nobody controls the pace of a match. Could this be it?
I think so.
The referee getting involved now.
And now a drop kick. What an acrobatic move.
Man, that was a pretty drop kick.
And there's the count.
I got a sharp pain in my neck just watching that neck breaker.
Yeah, I got a much lower pain, but I don't want to talk about it right now.
Three.
I just can't get over the physicality of this match. This has been brutal.
Brutal and very, very painful for these guys.
You have to wonder just how widespread the back pain is. We'll find out soon enough.
No kidding. This is bad.
He gets the tag.
And he finally gets out of the ring.
Wow, that overhand punch started down behind his feet and just kept coming.
Woo-hoo, man, that came out of left field.
It seems the focus of his onslaught is directly on the back. This is going to be brutal.
Yeah, that back is in bad shape.
Good grief! How is he still conscious? Oh, and a terrific reversal.
Not today, too fast.
And a great shot by Lord Steven Regal.
And the offensive display by Lord Steven Regal.
This WWE action is helping you get through those midweek blues. Thank you for choosing to spend your Wednesday night with us. We appreciate you choosing WWE. This WWE action is helping you get through those midweek.
The shoulders are down.
Two.
And the ref starts to count.
Man, here's the Nature Boy. Is he styling and profiling in there or what?
Woo!
It's just a matter of time now.
And he's in there trying to get something going.
And this has got to be it.
Yeah, maybe. With a 180, Lord Steven Regal, the reversal.
And there's the count.
Ric Flair is taking complete and total control of this match. Look at him, Michael. I mean, those moves have really started to add up.
If you're just tuning in, I want to welcome everyone to this broadcast of WWE, coming to you from the capital of the Golden State, Sacramento.
Oh, nice counter. Oh, out of nowhere. He makes the tag.
And now he's back out on the apron.
R-Truth with a nice reversal.
Why is the guy his opponent? What's he going for here?
These guys are giving it absolutely everything they've got.
They're not holding anything back, and I love it.
Man, this has been a great matchup.
You're right about that, Cole. A Matt classic. What? He's still not through?
I don't think so.
Whoa, a direct hit. Talk about getting tagged and knocked in the middle of next week.
Great reversal. Oh, the reversal by R-Truth. He is just getting busted up. Shoulders are down.
And the ref starts to count.
Oh, wait, nice reversal.
Thank you for choosing to spend your Wednesday night with us. We appreciate you choosing WWE.
Somehow, he's kicked it into another gear here tonight.
Here we go. Barrett setting it up.
Barrett, what a maneuver.
Check that out. That's how effective offense can be when you're able to combine moves together.
Yep, there's the reversal by R-Truth.
truth with the offense.
Boy, he just laid out.
Now this is punishment. I've never heard of victory by using the same move, but we could see it here tonight.
Well, it seems to be working fine so far.
There's no quitting these guys, but unfortunately, only one of them can be victorious here tonight.
Ow! Ooh, good grief! How is he still conscious?
He gets the tag. This takes the adage of practice makes perfect and takes it in a completely new direction.
No kidding. Over and over, the same new direction.
Quick thinking to avoid that.
Beautiful escape by Lord Steven Regal.
You know, even on defense, Regal is just so dangerous.
Lord Steven Regal going to work now.
He's got to be history. Is he still even conscious? Oh, man.
This should do it right there.
I think this is it.
The referee getting involved now. And there's the count.
The reversal from Nate.
How much more damage can the neck take?
He's really been zeroed in on, but he's still showing some signs of life. He's still not through. And momentum has changed once again. Oh, man. I thought he might have been knocked out right there. When he gets going like this, there are a few better.
Man, this is one of those matches you just like to sit back and enjoy watching.
Yeah, one of those you never want to see end.
The offensive Lord Steven Regal is working well right now.
Oh, and bad news, Barrett getting on a roll here. As we're seeing, if anyone in WWE likes taking the fight to an opponent, it's Wade Barrett.
If you're just tuning in, I want to welcome everyone to this broadcast of WWE, coming to you from the capital, the Golden State, Sacramento. Finley is tagged in.
Oh, wow. Oh, what a shot. That did some serious damage. You can't take too many of those and expect to be in the match much longer.
Unleashing it for the second time now.
He has just worn him out.
He's moving like a man possessed.
Wow, did you see that? Almost don't want to see what's next. What a move.
And it's Lord Steven Regal with the reversal.
There's the super.
He thinks he has it.
One, two, three.
There's your winner, ladies and gentlemen. Three have to be happy with their performance here tonight.
Anytime you can pick up a win inside a WWE ring, you have something to be extremely proud of.
I wasn't completely convinced these three were on the same page throughout the entire match, but they were certainly able to overcome any potential issues to pick up the win.
WCW World Tag Team Championship. Introducing first, representing Chaos, from Marieville, Quebec, Canada, weighing in at 266 pounds, Kevin Owens.
Four of WWE's finest squaring off in what will assuredly be an exciting tag team encounter.
I'd say this team looks like they have what it takes to walk away victorious tonight.
See another hot one. These teams looking to make a mark here in the tag team division.
And in a few minutes, we will have a new champion. And there's the bell. This match has got the hair on the back of my neck standing up, Michael. This is going to be great. Oh, no. Wait a minute, Cole. What's he going to do here?
He's pressing all the right buttons now. As we watch Adam Rose, let's get your take on him.
Just by looking at Kevin Owens, I wouldn't think he'd be the type of superstar to pull off a moonsault. Then I saw him do it, and wow, was I ever amazed.
Well, luckily the body hasn't absorbed too much of an attack up to this point.
How much damage did that do?
A lot, from the looks of it.
And he brings the action back inside the ring.
Yeah, I think this is good strategy. After a move like that, he's going to need a chiropractor in his near future. The moonsault's not the only move Kevin Owens will surprise you with. He's also been known to execute a flawless senton bomb from time to time.
Yeah, and guys like Kevin Owens aren't usually the ones you see doing a senton bomb. That's typically reserved for the smaller guys. He makes the tag! Now with complete control. Rose unable to be contained.
And he finally gets out of the ring.
And he's heading back in.
I can't blame him. Nothing good is going to happen out here on the floor.
Direct hits like that help put your opponent away fast and early.
You know, we can talk about all the different moves that Daniel Bryan has in his collection. And believe me, there's no shortage of them. But I think the one the crowd likes to see above all the others is the surfboard. Did you see that?
What's he gonna do here? What's he gonna do here?
And tagged in is Kevin Owens. It looked like his whole neck just crumbled there. Maneuvers like that put everybody in danger.
No kidding, that's awful.
A quick reversal by Kevin Owens.
You know, Daniel really has mastered the surfboard. If he has his opponent, and there it is, the sharpshooter. Searing pain has to be going through that lower back.
I guess he's done with that move.
Yeah, but what's he gonna do next?
Oh, wait, nice reversal.
Just making his presence felt there.
Reversal. Kevin Owens showing his skills.
Uh-oh.
What force on that slam?
The tag is made.
When his strikes land, you can feel it in the first few rows.
Ow!
These competitors will always be looking to unleash their finishing maneuver, and when that happens, the complexion of the match can change in a heartbeat.
You're right about that. The entire match can end in a heartbeat if somebody hits their big move.
Very few individuals in the history of this business can make an audience literally stop what they're doing just by making an appearance. Kevin Nash is on top of that list. Intimidating, powerful, merciless. These are all adjectives that have described Kevin Nash from the moment he entered sports entertainment, and everyone knows it.
Boy, he just got laid out.
If you haven't done it yet, check out WWE.com. You'll find updates and blogs from all your favorite superstars.
Yeah, and don't forget to check us out on Twitter. It's at Jerry Lawler and at Michael Cole. Right, Michael Cole?
Yeah, that's original.
And now he's back out on the apron.
Cole, you mentioned the instant attention that Kevin Nash commands when he enters an arena. Nothing could be more accurate. The unanimous thought is, if Nash appears, it's for a specific reason, and it you. The shoulders are down! Two!
Man, Kevin Owens, what offense! There's the switch.
Not a lot of spring left in his step right now.
Not today, too fast!
He's got to be vigilant about not taking any more damage to the neck. King, we both know Kevin Nash earned his reputation of striking first and asking questions later, but it amazes me that wherever we go in WWE's travels, the crowd knows it. Each person knows that Kevin Nash can be as cold-blooded and ferocious as they come.
Well, Kevin Nash's history of acting without remorse has certainly followed him wherever he's gone. The WWE fans have long memories, and when they see Nash, they know someone is most likely going to get hurt. It's just a matter of how badly and how many people are included in the beating. Oh, man, cutting off circulation to the brain. You could pass out from a hold like that.
Strikes like that can end this one in a hurry.
You know, looking into the rearview mirror to 2013, Daniel Bryan headlined some of the biggest events on the WWE calendar, and he definitely had his ups and downs. But the highs of that roller coaster ride were pretty darn high. I mean, we've heard him talk about how much Team Hell Knows When at WrestleMania 29 meant to him.
Daniel and Kane were at their peak when they defended their tag team titles that night. Team Hell No dominated Dolph Ziggler and Big E.
And remember, the title is on the line here tonight. We are guaranteed a new champion.
And I can only imagine the pressure these competitors are feeling right now, knowing that the gold is on the line.
I remember a few big events in 2013 that didn't go as well for Daniel Bryan as the one you just pointed out, though, King. The Wyatt family ate Daniel's lunch at TLC that year. He put up one heck of a fight to even hang around as long as he did in that three-on-one battle, but that night took its toll on him.
Look out!
Quick thinking to avoid that.
Look at him out there, reaching for the tag. He can't wait to get back in the mix.
He doesn't want to do this outside the ring.
Well, I don't blame him. Keep the action inside the ring. That's where you're going to win this thing. Hey, the shoulders are down.
Well, if you're going to talk about Daniel Bryan's epic performances in 2013, King, we can't leave out maybe the biggest one of all. The Night of Champions, when Daniel Bryan became the champion by taking out the Apex Predator, Randy Orton.
Well, it was a championship Daniel didn't get to hold on to for very long, but it still showed that when Daniel Bryan is at the top of his game, even an all-time great superstar like Randy Orton is no match for him.
Oh, man, from the High Rent District!
I wouldn't know what that's like.
Look out. I think Adam Rhodes is getting the Exotic Express ready to roll. Just watch him put a little extra mustard on that hot dog.
Going for the cover.
One, two.
A lot of pride on the line here in this tag team encounter, but only two of these competitors will end up getting what they came for. The win.
Isn't it just like Adam Rose to have a signature move called the party foul? It really is party time all the time with this guy. I love it. Are we gonna see it?
Kevin Owens hit that one. Will it be?
One, two.
We've got everybody going at it now. Getting involved now.
Oh, looking to make a statement here.
Pop a power bomb. Kevin Owens gonna end it right here.
Kevin Owens been very successful with a pop a power bomb.
What do you have to do to keep this guy down? Quickly back to Adam Rose's party foul finisher. It sounds fun, but I assure you, it's all impact. Rose literally drives his opponent's head into the mat face first. There's almost no getting up from it.
Well, if the threat of that doesn't motivate you not to be a lemon, I don't know what will. Oh, wait, nice reversal. That'll put you on a doctor's table. Look at him, Michael. I mean, those moves have really started to add up.
A quick reversal by Kevin Owens. Making a statement here.
Much more of that, and he's not going to last long.
In off the tag is Kevin Nash. And he finally gets out of the ring. Now here's something about Daniel Bryan that sets him apart from other WWE superstars.
What's that, Mike?
And Kevin Nash makes him pay in the worst way on that exchange. To the cover.
The ref's out.
Daniel Bryan goes with a kneeling kick combo. Won't be long now.
Yeah, Daniel Bryan has got his opponent on the ropes. He should end this quickly.
Wait a minute.
And into the cover.
One, oh, and he's going to have to do something big here. His partner is in bad shape.
Not every move is designed to get the fans off their feet.
Stay down! Stay down!
And the ref starts the count.
Look out! Nowhere to go! There's no escaping this!
Man, oh man, did he take a wild...
And he lets him out!
Well, he might have been losing some of his grip there anyway. He probably figured it would be better to release the hold now before his opponent could counter it.
There it is! Jackknife powerbomb!
That is an impressive move right there.
Oh man, there's the finisher!
They're going for the cover. Good tag team match, and this one was unforgettable. I mean, these teams gave us everything they had, and the WWE Universe is the true winner in this one.
And don't forget, you and I, we have the best seats in the house.
Hey, this isn't just about going out there and making sure everybody's entertained. You've got to win your matches, and that's exactly what happened here. A will to win was on display.
The crowd here tonight certainly seemed to appreciate the efforts. What a great match.
Six-man tag team matches would benefit from a second referee on the outside. There's just too much going on for one official to handle.
How long have you contested that?
Teams of three coexist once the bell rings.
Okuda, weighing 257 pounds, Mr. Perfect.
I can't think of a time I've seen the WWE Universe this pumped up. What a match we're seeing. Expecting plenty of highlight reel material in this one.
It's not very often you see this much star power in the ring at the same time.
Reminds me of me being in the ring with me.
And there's the bell.
This big six-man tag match is underway and it's already action-packed. You look back at the all-time great six-man teams and they all share the same trait. Great teamwork.
Oh, he's gonna have to block out the pain if he hopes to escape this.
And there's an extremely destructive strike.
HBK sees the opportunity.
Checking out Triple H. What can you tell us right now?
You know, they say a carpenter's only as good as his tools. Well, there's no one better utilizing all his tools to defeat an opponent than Triple H. I mean, the Harley Race high knee, the Arn Anderson spine buster, and the pedigree. They're all awesome. When the Cerebral Assassin has you in his sights, that can only mean bad news.
Shawn Michaels is not liking this.
Mr. Perfect showing us how to get it done.
How's he doing this?
Not today, too fast. And now he's back out on the apron.
King, you talked before about a carpenter using his tools. The game is so adept at picking an opponent apart, piece by piece, until that opponent is rendered defenseless. The consummate combatant, Triple H indeed, has many weapons to choose from. Look out! Doing a great job of avoiding any serious offense. That'll go a long way as this one progresses.
Looks like he's pinpointing the back.
Mr. Perfect on a good pace now.
This is just the way Mr. Perfect likes it.
Hump day! Hopefully this WWE action is helping you get through those midweek blues. When you discuss all the moves that are at Triple H's disposal, it illustrates almost instantly why he's the Cerebral Assassin. Something to also remember, where you see Triple H, you know his equalizer, the Sledgehammer, is not far behind.
Well, Michael, it's tough not to talk about all of Triple H's weapons. When you bring the Sledgehammer into it, it makes the game that much more intimidating and lethal.
This might be big. Oh, man. Hurting the ribs and the lower back. That just takes all of the power out of you. He's in big trouble.
And there's the tag. Look at Mankind here.
You know, guys, I don't know if there's anyone more twisted.
More blood. Oh, my gosh! They can't breathe! He looks absolutely unstoppable here.
Look at Mankind here. Stop might have only lasted a second, but it's going to be felt tomorrow.
That may be felt for a lifetime.
Not today, too fast.
Triangle stretch.
The triangle stretch, one of my all-time favorites. Mankind reverses it.
Moments ago, King, you mentioned Mankind's penchant for maiming his opponents. When he jams his fingers down a human being's esophagus with a mandible claw, you can bet serious injury is just around the corner.
Well, I don't care how big, tough, strong, or brave you are. It's difficult to stop a certified lunatic. And that's exactly what an opponent has to deal with when going up against this freak.
Quick thinking to avoid that.
Look at this.
People have been wanting to see these guys go at it for a long time. And by the sound of this crowd, I think they're getting what they wanted. Going for the cover.
Two.
Not today. Too fast.
If he keeps up this pace, this could turn real ugly real fast.
When you're in the ring with The Rock, you have to do everything in your power to avoid that spine buster, because you know what comes right after that.
He gets the tag.
He's got him hooked.
What a match this is going
to
be.
I've been looking forward to this one for a long time, Cole.
And here comes the Heartbreak Kid. Trust me, I know what this feels like. HBK is considered by many as the greatest performer our business has ever known.
And the offensive display by Shawn Michaels. To King's earlier point, once The Rock hits that spine buster, you can almost guarantee the people's elbow is next, which has resulted in an arena is coming virtually unglued.
And equally as dangerous, though, would have to be The Rock's sharpshooter. Of course, it was that move that controversially awarded The Rock his first ever WWE Championship at the 1998 Survivor Series.
Yep, there's the reversal by Shawn Michaels.
Three.
Quick thinking to avoid that.
This is a level of destruction no one was expecting.
I certainly didn't expect to see this kind of damage.
Well, we're on the move here.
Triple H has really gained some ground here with his fantastic offense.
Six.
He wants back in this match in the worst way.
It goes without saying that The Rock is among the most charismatic superstars the sports entertainment industry has ever seen.
Oh, that's true, Michael. But The Rock's not just all glitz and catchphrases. He also knows what he's doing inside that ring. Hence, all the championships.
Uh-oh.
You can bet every superstar on the roster is crowded around the monitors in the back to see which one of these guys comes out victorious. Some very opportunistic offense here. There's no quit in these guys, but unfortunately only one of them can be victorious here tonight. I do not doubt The Rock's ability inside that ring for 1 second, King. All I'm saying is that there's a reason why The Rock is known as the most electrifying man in sports entertainment, and that's his unmatched charisma. Shawn Michaels switches it up.
HBK can be so unpredictable.
That was rough.
Well, out here you have to be able to think on your feet lightning fast. One mistake, one moment of hesitation, and you could find yourself in a world of hurt.
He's too good inside the ring to be out on the floor for long.
I don't agree with you, King. There it is, the single leg camel clutch.
Camels are crying all over the country. Well, the longer he stays in this, the closer he is to losing the match.
The Rock's charisma is undeniable, Michael. I'll give you
the single leg Boston Crab.
Oh, man, a hole named after the Bean Town.
No love lost between these two. This match will have a lot of big moves. One question will be, who will...
Nobody comes back from this. Going for the cover.
Two.
Mankind making his statement as we speak.
Uh-oh, big move coming.
Watch it, watch it. Mandible claw, the big man has got this.
Oh my goodness, that nasty, filthy mandible claw stuck right down his opponent's throat.
Cole, the last thing I...
This might be it.
One, two.
Some competitors just have a move they trust more than others. Thank you for choosing to spend your Wednesday night with us. We appreciate you choosing WWE. From our vantage point, it doesn't even look like a sweat has been broken.
I'm willing to bet there are plenty of superstars who share your feeling on the mandible claw, King, and this has got to be it.
I think so.
Two.
The referee getting involved now. And there's the count. Oh, my gosh, big time impact.
And here's the tag. He's simply reminding him that he's here.
Look out. No, wait, nice reversal.
Boom!
Mr. Perfect reverses it.
Nice job, Mr. Perfect.
After a move like that, he's going to need a chiropractor in his near future.
He's in big trouble.
I can't help but think of his risk of internal injuries at this point in time.
Yeah, this could get
covers. That elbow will leave you dazed. I'm having a hard time figuring out what they're going to do next.
Me too. I've given up even trying to figure out what they're going to do next. I'm just sitting back watching and enjoying.
There it is, the camel clutch.
Oh, man, good luck on getting out of that one. Oh, man.
I don't believe the destruction we're seeing.
This guy's just going from one painful move to another.
He lands the strike with great accuracy. He'll be feeling the effects of that for a while. He's delivering an old-fashioned butt kicking right here.
Whoa, whoa!
Ramon, there it is.
Man, that could be the difference maker for Ramon.
Here's the cover.
One, two.
Hump day. Hopefully this WWE action is helping you get through those midweek blues. And there's the tag. Mankind into the ring.
Oh, wow.
Here we go. It's gotta be over now.
Great counter.
Mankind with a nice reversal.
Hey, he's going for it again.
Mandible claw.
Oh, one of the most brutal moves ever.
I guess he's done with that move.
Yeah, but what's he gonna do next? And the ref starts to count.
Two.
And there's the count. Ow! Ooh, how impressive was that? The Rock turns it around. Trying to build some offense. He's got him. Uh-oh.
He's throwing the rule book out the window.
Going for the cover.
Man, he just got nailed.
Michael, I think Triple H is injured. Could this be it for the King of Kings?
Well, he's got his opponent, and what's he going for here?
Looks like he's pinpointing the back.
The longer this match goes, the more moves like that will add up.
Not today, too fast.
Mankind is doing what he loves best, dealing out pain.
My God, his body's been through hell, and his ribs have bore the brunt of the attack.
Man, I hope he doesn't grieve. Oh, out of nowhere. Wow, he's still down after that. This could do it.
Maybe.
Two.
Oh, and there goes the ref. The official is out of it.
Oh, wait. Nice reversal.
A suplex like that takes a lot of power and delivers a lot of impact.
Oh, man. How do you stand after an attack like this?
The shoulders are down.
If you're just tuning in, I want to welcome everyone to this broadcast of WWE, coming to you from the capital of the Golden State, Sacramento. He gets the tag.
Ow! Hard kick to the ribs. Oh, no. Wait a minute, Cole. What's he going to do here?
We're looking at complete domination here.
It only takes a couple of those to bring his night to an end.
He gets the tag.
Man, he's still down after that move. I almost wonder if his bell got seriously rung there. There's the tag, and he's ready to roll. He's showing no signs of letting up. This may settle the score, but that's it. He's out.
It may be. The action spills out to the ringside area, where there are plenty of toys to help inflict damage. These superstars looking for a victory, looking to build momentum.
You're right about that. Momentum is so important in a match like this.
Each of these competitors is looking for the slightest hint of weakness in the other.
Well, that's a strategy you have to always have in the back of your head, Cole. If you ever see a weakness in your opponent, you gotta jump on it.
Tell you, these guys are in the best shape I've ever seen them in. The Rock works his way out of trouble.
Well, you talk about a lightning fast counter, Cole.
Quick thinking to avoid that.
He's inflicting some serious pain here.
There's some serious power right there. Reversal. Oh, when the game gets on a roll like this, he's incredibly difficult to stop.
Watch it. Watch it.
Triple H. What a maneuver.
He's setting it up. Triple H setting it up. Oh, that's it. That's got to be it. Triple H. Now, that's a finishing move, people.
And he goes for the cover.
This is it.
Two. What a win. Man, he's got to feel great.
Here are your winners. The game, Triple H, Mr. Perfect, and The Rock.
Nice teamwork by these three to pick up the win.
Man, you can bet there's going to be a celebration tonight.
And I can imagine there aren't too many people at home regretting tuning in for that amazing match. Wow.